Called Eden, E-D-E-N. And then, in that garden, in that beautiful spot, he created the first man. And what was his name? Adam, A-D-A-M. And then, to give him a companionship, a consort, a lady, he created Eve, E-V-E. Adam is man, Eve is woman. These were in Eden, and they were all created by God. And then he told them, my dear Adam, my dear Eve, for your pleasure, for your peace, for your happiness, I have created you. I want you to be blissful. I want you to be peaceful. I want you to be cheerful. Enjoy the garden. Be peaceful always. Be happy always. And at the end, God said, Mr. Adam, Eve, there is a tree. I have created a tree. Yes, boss. On that tree, there is a fruit. Yes, sir. Don't go to that tree. Yes, sir. Don't touch that fruit. Yes, sir. Don't eat that fruit. Yes, sir. What happens, sir, if I eat that fruit? You will suffer. You will have pains. You will have problems. You will have to endure constant suffering. You become sinners. Why do we become sinners? Obedience is virtue. Disobedience is sin. I am God. I tell you not to touch the fruit. Be obedient to me. Be virtuous. Be good. Be the children of merit, ananda, eternity, immortality. If you disobey, that means you are sinners. Disobedience is sin. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. They said, God went away. And then this man Adam, that woman Eve, looked at the tree. It's beautiful, enticing, fascinating. Don't look at the veranda. But the more you are asked not to look at the veranda, you feel like looking at the veranda. There is a beautiful girl. Don't look at her. Silently. Don't wink at her. Without the knowledge of my father, without the knowledge of my teacher, without the knowledge of anybody, silently, slowly, I do. Why do students fail the examinations? Co-education school, co-education college, co-education university. Poor lecturers, professors will be delivering lectures. Be virtuous, be good, have concentration. Every day listening to the same story of Bhagavad Gita, let the teacher speak. Slowly on the next page, the beautiful girl. No lesson is seen. There is disobedience to the teacher and there is a sin committed. The result, we fail the examinations. We lose the job, we don't get the money. All because of disobedience. Adam and Eve were asked not to go to the fruit, they went. Asked not to touch the fruit, they touched. Asked not to eat the fruit, they ate. And now the gentleman was talking to Swami Vivekananda. And then Vivekananda was asking, and the elderly gentleman was giving the reply, and then useless people, the first man, the first woman, tell Why did they fall? Because of disobedience. They have fallen from goodness, from kindness, from eternity, from immortality, from peace, from ananda, from happiness. Now, when a man is walking well dressed on the road, by a slip he fell into the ditch water by the side of the road. His clothes became dirty. Which is his original place? Is that the road or the ditch water? He fell into the ditch from the road. He fell into the suffering from happiness. He fell into the sin from virtue. Originally he is good. He is a son of God. She is daughter of God. Which do you say? What is your original position? Is it the fallen position which is our original? Or is it the position from where we have fallen? From where did we fall? We fell from obedience to disobedience. We fell from virtue to sin. We fell from happiness to suffering. We fell from hell to ill-health. Anandam Brahme. What is our original position? Swami Vivekananda spoke very little. He was asking the man, why are we sinners? Because our ancestors, our forefathers, the first man, the first woman, fell from, Vivekananda asked. The reply is given. From the same person he was able to elicit the answer, the original position is blissful. And that's what our Vedanta says. That's our Yoga Shastra says. That's our philosophy spoken by the Upanishads. We are having five koshas. One is the body. We are very much aware of it. Two legs, two hands, two eyes, nose, ears, head, feet, knees. This is the structure. Flesh, blood, blood vessels, skin. This is the human structure, body. How do we get it? From the elements, from the five elements of nature, from earth, from water, fire, air, space. You have earth outside, calcium inside, bones that represent the earth. We have the fire, we have the warmth inside. We have the water outside, we have the fluids inside. We have space outside and we have the space inside. This body is nothing but a representative of the five elements, Pancha Bhutas, and each is food to something else. This body is food after death to the animals. Everybody takes somebody's food. Rat is food to cat. Cat is food to dog. Dog is food to another animal. Everything is food, and this is Annamaya Kosha. This is food to somebody. It requires food from somebody. Every day we do consume. Every day we feed directly or indirectly. It is a cycle of food. And therefore, in Sanskrit, food is anna, stula, cross, physical body, biological body. Is that you? No. It's only a mass of flesh. It is there in it, life force, prana. Without that life, five vital gates, this body is useless. So, which is more important, body or the life spirit? Life. And there is a man, is living, he is breathing, he is in a state of coma. What is there? Life is there, breathing is there, but useless to himself and to others. There should be mind. He must be moving. He must be able to feel the senses. Body is important, and then vital is prana is important, and then inside we have the wonderful mind. In a hospital, Nimhans, Bangalore, there are people, mad people. They have the body, they have the life, they have the mind, but the mind does not have the intellectual aspect. They behave like cracks. They shout, they jump, they are mentally not well, disabled. What is important then? Brain. And that brain is vijnana. Is that over? No. We would like to be peaceful. We would like to be blissful. And that is the core product. First sheet is body. Second inside is life. Third inside is mind. In the mind there is brain, intellect, and then it is also peeped into, probed into, penetrated into, pierced in it. We find something peaceful, something blissful, and something ananda, and that is you. The fruit has the outer skin, plum, and the core product, and that's the same story is beautifully told in our Indian mythology. Prakriti is nature, and Prakriti is Parvati. She is energy, Shakti, and this nature is Veni. She has applied the turmeric powder all over the body. From the turmeric powder, when it came out, she made a small toy boy, Vigneshwara. And that baby is made up of Mother Nature's turmeric powder. It is a representative of the nature. And a small boy is made, a toy is made, the Mother Nature looked at the boy. Beautiful, wonderful. Why can't this boy be given a life? And she infused the life into that boy, and the boy started moving. There is energy infused. There is energy injected. Mother Parvati, Mother Nature, energy gave the toy, gave the doll, gave the bomma the energy. Now the boy is moving. Mother told, my dear son, go to the door. Yes, ma. You walk up and down. Yes, ma. I am going to my washroom. I shall take bath. Don't allow anybody inside the house. Yes, ma. Computer is bought, electricity is connected, program is the computer. This body is the machine computer. It is given the life, electricity, and it is programmed. The dog is programmed, cat is programmed. We are also programmed. When there is gulab jam, this machine is programmed in such a way that there is water oozing from the tank. Instinct. When there is a girl walking in the veranda, the body is so programmed, eyes will turn that side. Dog in India, dog in America will behave the same way. A cat of Africa and a cat in Australia Australia will behave in the same way. They are all programmed. We are also programmed up to that mind. Then, the boy has gone out, a programmed computer, a robot. Oh, no originality, no thinking. The boy is moving up and down as directed by the mother, as programmed by the scientist, and it is moving up and down. The boy toy Vinayaka, handsome, with vital energy, with the mind, with a pepper inside, was walking up and down. Shiva came. Father came. Parvati's husband came. Who are you? He doesn't know. No brain, no intellect, no questioning. And a dog looks at another dog and pounces. It's after all my son, let him also, even though he doesn't think. The mother dog fights with the daughter dog. Father dog fights with the son dog when there is a piece of bone. It is programmed to bark. It is programmed to shout. It is programmed to bite. All dogs all over the world behave the same way. All cats behave the same way. And this is a robot. This is a computer programmed. This boy is walking up and down. Shiva came. Father, he doesn't know. He does not use the brain. You cannot go in. I am programmed to stop anybody entering the house. You idiot, it's my house, fellow. Nothing doing about that. Father got angry. He took the trident, chopped off the head of his son. Later, Mother Nature came. Father looked. What a mistake we committed. The boy has only 3 things. Body he has. Life he has, mind he has, brain he does not have. Brain is to be brought from some place. The biggest brain, the largest head is that of the elephant. Symbolically, it is the biggest brain. Lion is fond of the brain in the head of the elephant. Elephant's head was broad because of his weak brain. It is very highly intellectual. Father and mother brought that head, placed it, fixed it. Now, Vigneshwara has 4 parts. Body he has, life he has, mind he has, brain also discrimination, Vigyanamaya Kosha. First is Annamaya Kosha body. Second is the vital body, Pranamaya Kosha. And the third is Manomaya Kosha, mind. And the fourth is Vijnanamaya Kosha. He is now peaceful. He is able to know who is the mother, who is the father. Brain is working. And then came the great public relations officer, marriage broker, media person, intellectually eloquent, elevating, spiritual, jained, Narada. Naram Tadati Narada. Whoever gives you wisdom is Narada. He has arrived and he brought this fruit. Fruit of wisdom, fruit of enlightenment, fruit of bliss. And he told Shiva, please give this to your one of his sons. One is Vigneshwara, another is Kartikeya, fruit is one. He offered in a competition. My dear children, whoever goes around the world first comes and salutes us will get this. Scientist is Kartikeya, spiritual giant is Vigneshwara. Scientist made the search outside, spiritual giant turned inside. Vigneshwara went round mother and father, Prakriti and Parameshwara. Our rishis probed deep. Ramaharshi closed his eyes, thought, all contemplation, am I the body? No. Am I the life? No. Am I the mind? No. Am I only the intellect? No. These are all only parikaranas to know who I am. He went on probing deep, and he was able to realize he was the Atma Swarupa. So also Sri Ramakrishna, this is the Indian culture, yogic culture, to probe deep, and Vigneshwara was able to realize the two, Parvati and Parameshwara, the soul and the entire manifestation of the Atman Jagat. He went round. There are two people, spiritual people realize the Brahman. Scientists also discover the ultimate truth. Science should advance to such a great extent wherein it can meet the spirituality. They both will shake hands. Path of Kartikeya is a spiritual path. Nahi. It is the scientific path. The way of Vigneshwara is the spiriritual path. Oriental Indian tradition, yogic tradition, is to know who I am ultimately. Science also does discover, but it is a little late. Now, Vigneshwara was able to find that he is the Atman, he is the son of Parvati and Parameshwara, Shrunmantu Vishye Amdasya Putra, he is the children of eternity, Swami Vivekananda. The entire Vedic literature of this country, the entire Upanishad literature of this country, the entire Itihasa literature of this country, the entire mythological literature of this country, the entire ritual practices of this country take us to the ultimate reality, the absolute reality that I am the Brahman, I am divine. I am eternal, I am not the body, I am not the life, I am not this mind, I am not even the intellect. There is something in me, there is enlightenment, Divya Jyoti, Jnana Jyoti, Brahmananda, Akhandam, Anandam, Advitiyam, Achintyam, Achyutam. I am that everlasting, ever shining divinity, that is what is to be ultimately discovered by us, the practitioners of yoga. Five layers, five sheaves, we go deep and discover that we are all the children of eternity. May we realize that Brahman. Let us make full use of our practice of yoga and attain that Brahmahood. Let us meditate, step after step, go deep. Body is transcended, life too, go beyond the mind, probe very clearly into the intellect. There is